Hey guys, I got a new video here for you. This was sent in to me by someone, not sure what server he plays on, but I'm just going to call him Doc, because his name says Doc something. So he's playing with his platoon mate in the ISU 152, which is an amazing tank. Probably one of the most fun tanks to play in the whole game. Although you do have to really camp a lot in this tank, which is unfortunate because it's got a slow traverse. You can't sort of brawl. You basically have to snipe and just wait for shots to appear. But this game, Doc didn't have to wait too long. There's plenty of shots in this game, so it was a pretty good game. So this is a tank that you don't want to get flanked by mediums and lights. If they get your side, you're pretty much toast. There's nothing you can do. But if you keep everyone at long range and just use that amazing gun, then you can have a great time. Unfortunately, his platoon mate doesn't have the BL-10 gun yet, so he's using the SU-152 derp gun. At first I thought he was just a complete idiot shooting HE all the time, but I realised he had a derp gun, so that's why he's shooting HE. He hasn't unlocked the top gun yet, so that's a bit unfortunate for him, but he still manages to do a bit of damage, so Doc's just trying to get in position to find a few shots here, and can't quite get a shot on anyone yet, but there's plenty of tanks over there, so it's just a matter of time before shots appear. And BL-10 has, well, there was a shot, it just was a bit too quick to get that one off. But yeah, the BL-10 has an amazing 286mm of penetration and 750 alpha damage, which is, for a tier 8 tank, is just amazing. Like, well, here's a shot. Nice, good hit. Bit of a low roll, 600 and something, but... And his platoon mate manages to set him on fire as well, so that was a nice shot. Yeah, so I mean, 286 penetration would be an amazing penetration for a tier 10 tank, but this is on a tier 8 tank, so you pretty much just can go through anything you fire at. Only thing you can't go through is like really strong turrets, like an IS-7 turret, or don't know about a T-30 turret, probably not, but yeah, so it's is there a shot? Not quite. One of those tanks where you don't need to bring many gold shells, that's for sure. That was a bit of an unfortunate shot. He should have aimed that a little bit to the left and he would have hit, but not to worry. There's an FCM there. This FCM is just completely unaware. If I was in this matchup on the enemy team and I saw two ISUs and an Object 704, I would be expecting them to be here and I would be not poking from this angle. But can we get another shot before they get too close, maybe? Can't quite hit that one. So they're both backing up so they don't get lit and shot, which is probably a smart move, although if it was me I probably would have tried to get one more shot off before I backed up, but no harm in being a bit cautious, I guess. Have a target. All he can see is the turret, but he's gone for the cupola. Very lucky to hit that one. The gun did what it needed to, and that was a nice hit. Now his friend with the HE shell is probably going to finish him off. Hopefully. Yep, he finishes him off. Nice work. And now we've got a Mutz. He's just going to sit still in front of an ISU, so more damage. He'll take it. Very nice. And now there's this one WZ132 who's on less than 750 HP, so one shot should kill him. And he low rolls. But luckily he only takes track damage in return, so not too bad. Now that guy damages his gun, that's a bit annoying. Poor WZ132, trapped between a rock and a hard place, nothing he could do there. gun. I was going to say, I was wondering if he was going to play the rest of the match with the damaged gun. But he fixed the gun, so that's good. Now, nice lead on that shot. It actually would have hit, but his friend beat him to it, so he didn't quite get that kill. So now we have 4 TDs defending against 4 medium tanks. And if I was to place a bet, I would place a bet on the medium tanks because they're generally able to outposition and outmaneuver the TDs and get their flanks and kill them that way, but we'll see what happens here. We'll see how it goes. I'll just speed up the replay here a bit because I didn't want to wait too long. So, shouldn't be too long to wait before someone appears. They're all facing this way, so this is the right way to... Well, there's a nice shot on the M46. So they outguessed those mediums. They were facing the right way, the way in which they came. They had it completely lined up correctly. So that was a nice play by everyone there. And this M46 is going to poke again. Ouch. That's one mistake I bet he regrets. You did not want to poke front on against an ISU. Nobody wants to take that hit. Not even a tier 10 wants to take that hit. .704 rams the Centurion to death, so nice. And now there's just one Leopard left against this ISU, Doc in his ISU, and the 704. And unfortunately the Leopard's gone around the long way, he didn't quite realise that, and he takes a shot for nothing and his gun's damaged again. This time he can't fix the gun, so he's already used his repair kit. So 704 is going in, charging headfirst into this Leopard. The right play now would be to go up this first aisle and trap the Leopard so he has nowhere to go, but it appears that he might have already left, which was probably a smart play. If you can't get their flanks, then don't fight them. That's basically how you fight TDs, especially with a 704 and an ISU with 1500 damage with those two shots. You definitely don't want to take those shots. So you either flank them or you run away. So they're covering one side each now, which is a pretty smart move. Bit of a wait here. I think I speed up the replay again here because there's a bit of waiting, so we'll just skip ahead through this. 704 is making some kind of a flanking maneuver here. But so far they haven't found anything, and it's a bit of a mystery where that Leopard's gone. I mean, you'd think if he'd just backed out and gone down into the swamp, they would have seen him. The 704 would have seen him, so it's a bit of a mystery as to where he is. He could be straight ahead on the one line. That's possible. Yeah, so I speed it up now, because you don't want to sit through all this waiting too long. 704's gone right around and he hasn't spotted the Leopard at all, so it's anyone's guess as to where the Leopard has gone now. So 704 is going right around, and looks like Doc is just going to cover him from the middle, which is probably a good play. And There we go, leopard spotted. He's in the middle of the swamp. I don't know what on earth he was hoping to achieve all the way over there. Like, there was really no chance of spotting these guys. They were generally bound to be camping base, so I don't know what the leopard was doing. Maybe he was just running away, maybe he doesn't want to fight them. So Doc's going to drop down, see if he can get a shot. Oh, bit of a clumsy fall there. And the 704 has put one into the leopard, so he's now on 400 and something HP. He's a one shot. And he's just made a big mistake. That's the end of him. GG. Nice game, Doc. Well played. So that's an ace tanker in the ISU 152, which is very nice, and a high caliber. Not bad at all. And pretty good game. 5.5k damage, very nice in a tier 8. That's a solid game. His platoon mate did 1700, so that's decent as well. And the 704 did 4k damage as well, so pretty good game all round. Well played, Doc. Thanks for sending it in, and see you soon. Bye.